know what time it is. Episode 9 of Jesus Fabianski's Realistic Player Career Mode. In this episode, stay tuned because it is his Premier League debut. It's going to be a great match, and I'll see everybody out there on the pitch. It's that time once again. We shall see what Jesus Fabianski can do for Middlesbrough FC. Now, if you don't know much about Jesus Fabianski, an Italian player, honestly, I kind of wanted to mold him after Balotelli. Kind of that stylish winger on the edge, but a little bit of Messi in there as well. So be ready for the crosses and the amazing passes. It's going to be Middlesbrough versus Bournemouth. And I mean, I'm very excited. It's the Premier League, and it's been so long since I played here. Jesus Fabianski already getting ready. Let's just move the ball around. Good play. Good play, fellas. There it is. Great move. And look at Jesus. A bit in the middle. I want to make sure to stay in my zone and stay where I need to be. Looking for the cross now. 18 on the move. And there it is. A great cut inside. Jesus calling for the ball. Wait a minute. A beautiful pass. Oh, what a skill. What skill. Waiting for it now. Holding the ball. Jesus Fabianski looking for the pass back. And there it is. Meffert. Ah, disappointing pass. And Aaron's going the other way now for AFC Bournemouth. This is James Fabianski's brother. His younger brother. Now, he is a winger. But do not mistake that for no goal scored. Already he scored 2 goals, I'm pretty sure. And look at this, already giving up goals on the back line. A great performance from Bournemouth to start off this match. And we're gonna have to fire back if we wanna win. You know, Premier League debuts go down in the history books for every single player that comes into the Premier League. Who knows if this is too big of a jump for Jesus? I mean, he jumped pretty much from Liga 3 in Germany all the way to the Premier League. I was ready for the championship, but a bit of a surprise. He's in the Premier League. Meffert looking for a beautiful pass, but no luck. And there it is. Good touch from Jesus. Looking to cut it back inside, and there it goes. Good hold, good hold. And there it is. Good step. Looking for the shot, maybe. Oh! Jesus Fabianski. A cheeky, cheeky finish. And I just found out his best shot. He cannot be stopped, and you must put a man pressed up on him because he will let it fly. Not that much pace, but the perfect amount of precision on that shot to knock it to the top left bins. And look, my American commentary, it's not too bad right now. I'm definitely hyped. 1-1, even Steven on the day, and Jesus Fabianski already showing up. Oh, ref! Thank you. That's what I'm saying. It did not look like that live for Jesus to be on the ground still, but that was definitely a meaty challenge. It was going to be high technical, but Milos Kirkez today with the yellow card to start off. Look at that slide. Oh, you got to be much more technical with that. And Jesus Fabianski looking for the free kick now, and it could be one. Oh, just off the wall and back into the net. No luck. Oh, could be a red. What? Wow. You don't expect those type of things in your very first match, a red card. I thought that was a bit... I don't know if that was really a red card, me personally. I'm not too sure about that. I thought that was a yellow card, but of course, Jesus Fabianski, not exactly what you want to see in your debut match, and we shall see exactly what this match has to turn up for us. And there it is on the day, Middlesbrough and AFC Bournemouth, a 1-1 draw, and I will see everyone back at the main menu. And here he is, the man, the myth already. Jesus Fabianski off the mark. Supporters love to watch special talents, players who can make a difference against any opponent. Jesus Fabianski definitely fits that bill. The local fans were excited when he signed, of course, and today Jesus Fabianski took a career step forward, scoring his first senior goal for Middlesbrough. Most observers are sure there'll be many more to come. A new hero at the club? We shall find out, everybody. I'll see all y'all in his next match. Hopefully with the victory, it was a draw. Still undefeated and hopes of winning the Premier League. We might have to call this one an episode of debuts. Here it is once again, Jesus Fabianski stepping up for the debut in the Carabao Cup. We saw what he did in his first match, so today I'm expecting another great performance. He had a red card coming out of the first half. It was back and forth, very nitty gritty, and we'll see exactly what he has in store. We're looking for 2 assists. If we can get that done, amazing. If we can't, we look to win the match. That's the most important thing, is get the win. Jesus pushing up. There it is. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Assist, gotta be. Get it in, get in. Ah, too high on the cross. Too much power. Jesus Fabianski is going to be here all day. Good touch. We got the advantage. Good turn. Jesus looking for the plays now. And there it is. He's dribbling through the whole defense. Looking for the pass now. Has to be through the legs. Not big. Call him up. A long distance player. I'm pretty sure it's Latte Laugh I'm going to go with. But let me know down below in the comment section who this man is. The number 9. We could be a top flight team this Premier League season. Look at this. Jesus Fabianski dribbling through everybody and passes it through his legs. Nutmegs the whole team right there. That nutmeg right there stood for every player on the pitch. Exactly what you want to see from a top flight player. Jesus Fabianski hitting the Premier League, absolutely running. Ah, almost a real good pass through his legs once again. But Jesus Fabianski knows what needs to be done. Defensive play is going to win this match for sure. And playing from the front is what we have in store. I'm going to make sure to press him up here. Good touch. What a pass. Jesus all the way. Jesus all the way. Give me that. All the way. I might be able to get hyped for that one. It's too easy. It's way too easy with Jesus Fabianski. Running down the pitch, flying and making the plays. That's exactly what you need from your right winger. He's going to set the players up, but it'll also get you a goal or two. Jesus Fabianski, man. Running down the whole pitch, and he makes sure to crack it every time. Right into the back of the net. Oh, look at that, man. Good dribble, but not good enough. Jesus on the ball now. Good touch. Looking to make the plays. They're pressing up crazy, and look at the pass from Jesus right off the boot. Smith switches the pitch, but a quick turnover and a good interception from the opposition. Oh, and he almost got nutmegged. But Jesus Fabianski, responsible for the victory today. One assist to the number 9, man. I'm pretty sure it was Latte Laugh. I'm not too sure exactly how to pronounce that one, but let me know down below because he is a true baller. He's a top baller. But Jesus Fabianski, one assist, one goal, plus the one match, and the man of the match. That's going to be 5 training drills, and I will see everyone back at the main menu. And here we are. Jesus Fabianski decided to hire a language coach. We know he's Italian. He did pick up German when he was playing in the Bundesliga 3, but now it is time for him to learn English. And of course, before this next one, we have 5 training drills to do. I'm gonna skip right past this. All right, sorry about that. I had to pretty much just get everything prepared and ready, but this is what we are covering. 5 drills due to him being man of the match, playing in the match, having a goal and an assist. He's gonna get his vision up to 80. The short pass we're working on as well. Dribbling, ball control, stamina, and sprint speed. Curve on a shot, the long shot, shot power, and free kick accuracy. Also, his long passing and his crossing, as well as his penalties and his finishing. The finishing is probably going to be the most important, simply because as it gets higher and higher competition, the goalie will be better and better, and that's going to be very tough to score those goals. So, right now, in the standings, before we jump into this match, we see Middlesbrough, down there at 15th place. But think about that, Middlesbrough. 0 goal differential, 3 goals against, and 3 goals for with 2 points. No losses. We see some teams above us, actually, with losses, which is pretty funky. And there is Manchester City at the very top with 3 wins. So hopefully today we get a victory and maybe start working our way to the top of the table. I'll see everybody out there when it's time for this match. All right, it's that time. And honestly, I'm not too sure right now how many matches we should do in each episode. I'm thinking each one should probably be a month on its own. But I know the Premier League debut was towards the end of, I think it's August or September. So we're going to probably play this month here, maybe make it 4 matches, and we'll see how it really looks in terms of time. I'm not going to be able to know until after, but it's that time to play some football. Here we go. Pertaris, Brentford. I know this team right here. Ivan Toney used to play for them, and then he went through a whole scandal, lost all those games. I think it was like 140 games he was betting on or something crazy. But they just suspended him, and Arsenal actually is talking about getting Ivan Toney, so that'd be awesome. I see my man, the number 9 striker, but I'm making a run. Wait a minute. Trivella, gotta be. Whoa! Cheeky finish! And Jesus Fabianski making sure that Di Maria, weak foot, 1-star weak foot, he's not going anywhere with the right. And look at this beautiful finish. That could have been a toe point shot all the way through. Look at this. Beautiful. It's just the precise striking. We know we upgraded the pace, the dribbling, the agility, and the shot power. So maybe that one just whizzed by the keeper without him saying anything about it. Ball in the air now, and it's looking to be played. And what a beautiful touch here. Middlesbrough in the attack, and I'm looking for the beautiful pass. There it is. Jesus, what a touch. What a move. Oh, what the f***? Excuse my language. I'm going to have to mute that one post. But this dude is the best striker I've ever played with. The one-time touch. And the thing about this club, I like them because they were formed after slavery. 1876. Beautiful touch, and look at the move. Latelaf. Let me know down below how to pronounce that name and if he's your favorite player. Maybe this is why y'all wanted me to come to Middlesbrough. This dude's the truth. He is really the truth. That's already 2 goals in 2 matches for him. He's going to be a top scorer this season. Maybe even break the record. Oh, wow. Good move. Wiesa and no luck. What a ball. Jesus. Step on it, man. Step on it. Yeah, yeah. Look at the play. Jesus Fabianski getting dirty. Getting scrappy. And there he is on the ball. Oh, no luck. They hating. I'm not even sure if we were at home. I'm pretty sure we were at Brentford's home arena. Actually, I don't think we were. I'm pretty sure we was at Middlesbrough's grounds. A great performance from Jesus once again. And matter of fact, I don't even think we need to recap this one. I'm going to move this episode along, and I'll see everybody in our next match, hopefully with the same type of performance today from Jesus. Of course, I was going to bring a great match to your attention once again in this episode. In this one today, I really have no expectations because I don't want to be disappointed. We're playing against Spurs today. Now, something in me, it's the Gooner in me, I really need to win against Spurs today. It doesn't matter what team I'm on. I don't want to see Spurs win the Champions League, the Premier League, or even a match against me. So hopefully for all the Arsenal fans out there, we can get this victory. And for all those out there that just don't like Spurs, already with an advantage. And look at Jesus. Oh, yeah, thank you, Son. Thank you. Look at him. Card already. Thank you. Heung-min Son. And everybody, look at Jesus. Gleamed up. Sun on his face. Glass skin. We are ready. And look at this. Moving right by him. Son almost took him out the whole play. I'm going to let my team pass it around today. That's how we're going to win against this great defense. Every time I play against Chelsea, they have one of the best defenses in the league. I don't know because they don't really like, unless I just don't be watching Spurs, but they don't seem to have the greatest defense when I'm watching them. Looking for the goal already. That goalie was not getting that one. Good block by the CB, but I think we got him today. It's going to be a Middlesbrough takedown, and here it is. Good touch. Jesus already looking for the plays. Ha! Quick one. Beautiful touch. Got him. Got him. Come on, man. It's the left foot. Jesus ain't missing with the left foot. And watch him turn it up and fly off to the sunset. We're getting ready. And man, come on, man. I got a big smile on my face because we're playing with Martin Odegaard here. What a play. Jesus link-up play. Looking like he's ready to go and play with Real Madrid. Let me know down below in the comment section if you made it this far in the video. Greatly appreciate it. Those watching right now, I'm going to make sure to take your opinions into thought the most because you're really supporting the channel. Let me know down below, where should we go? Like, should we leave England now that we're in the Premier League? Should we go to Germany, Italy, France? I don't know. Just let me know down below in the comment section, and I'll make sure to get over to that team as soon as possible. And look at that. Already we're making plays. Bangara. Azaz. Bangara, can you make this pass? Oh, my Lord. That was a horrible ball. Yeah, not what we wanted to see. I got to get on Son. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Wow. Wow. Went right back down there on us, and I mean, I'm not even sure who this striker is, but he moved fast. Look at this. Lost 26, right past 17, and the goalie, I'm pretty sure that might, I think that's Dieng, matter of fact. I think that's Dieng. He flew out. I did rush the keeper. Okay, I'm not going to lie, because he had no chance one-on-one. So I thought he was going to get the ball, and just was not exactly what we wanted to see. And look at Jesus, now working his feet. It's going to be tough to get through that. It's going to be very tough. Whoa! Jesus trying to get his get back on Son. Definitely not what you want to see from a first-year player. But look, yellow cards are just there to let him know. There it is. Good touch. Look at Jesus running on the Bulls. Got him. One more. Offside? What's the call? Oh, okay. I guess advantage. They're going to get me with that yellow card. The ref today is not playing. Mine was definitely a yellow card. And I really hope right now my mic is not, like my camera is not lagging because I had some issues with that. Definitely the best player on the pitch and I'm showing it by bossing it around. Looking for the beautiful pass. Not enough. Jesus still working. Good play, good play. Get there. Come on, fellas. Ah. Damn, Kovaleski. What the? Bro, he did 5 step-over moves. Kovaleski, of course, 21, the winger. Come on, intercept. Intercept, fellas. Intercept. Offside. Offside. That was offside anyways. I gotta get outside. I don't want to go too far outside where it's like I got no room to go back in. There it is. Ah, damn. It's back and forth right now for sure. It's anybody's match. And the fact that we're here right now just goes to show what Middlesbrough is all about. Let me know down below if Middlesbrough is your club that you support, because this career mode probably could be one of the best seasons for your team. They got promoted last season. I'm not sure how they finished. Woo! Kovaleski almost dunked on the whole center back lineup down there. And thank God he did not, because I'm not sure how we would respond in the second half. I'll see everybody when it's time to kick this ball around once again. Hopefully getting this win, because honestly, nobody likes Spurs. Look at Son trying to square up the right back who we just signed. It's just a lack of defense. You can tell the difference in quality and caliber, because that's his second goal today. He just went in there, drove up, and finished it like nobody's business. But I got something in store for him. He ain't doing nothing to us, but he got 2 goals on us because we ain't playing him right. There we go. Good job, Clark. That's how you play Son. Son is getting eliminated. As I say it, down 3-1 now in this match. Of course, Yeon Kim Son just went down there and absolutely got the goal. Man, you think that you have a good chance of winning this match, and then the second half, substitutions and game plan switches up and it's over. Come on, fellas, come on. We're gonna overload the left side, make it tough for them to guard. Overload, come on. One more. I'm running it. Jesus all the way. Jesus all the way. Gotta be. Jesus all the way. Go get the ball. It's time for historic moments to take place. Jesus Fabianski, not taking any time out of his game, grabs the ball and heads right back down the pitch. I knew it was going to work. We overloaded the left side and really attacked those wing backs and the center back. And I mean, 3v2, come on. With Jesus Fabianski, blazing speed, 93. It's going to be very tough to stop that man. We got about 5 minutes here to really work and make sure it's our game. Draw it up. Don't go backwards, fellas. I mean, sometimes Arteta said you have to go backwards to score, but Jesus Fabianski! Oh, no! Not enough elevation on a shot. It's not looking too good right now for us, but we have to make sure to make a play. I'm jumping down, trying to make sure everything is taken care of. Only 1 minute to play, and they keep it on the floor. Wow. I mean, we really showcased all our talents there. Jesus Fabianski, 2 goals on the day, almost a hat trick in his first ever episode in the Premier League. Just want to say thank you very much for tuning in, and I will see everyone back at the main menu for the recap. Of course, an episode, a great one, in fact, but a sad, sad ending. Middlesbrough, we really wanted to become that team to stay in the top 10, but now sitting at 13th, only 1 loss. I mean, come on. We've played 5, or we played 4, 1-1, drew 2, and lost 1. We're not bad. I mean, we have very high hopes for this season. And look at Spurs up there. 1 loss, we could have been their second loss. But let's take a quick look now at exactly what the stats are. So far in the season, we can see Shaik up there at the very top. But I want to see the assisters, because I'm not too sure where Fabianski is, but I'm pretty sure he has at least 1 assist this season. Now, of course, you're going to have names up there like Kevin De Bruyne and, you know, the other wingers and the midfielders that really, really pass the ball around. But here it is. Jesus Fabianski leading the team with 5 goals and 2 assists. Please let me know who this man is from the Ivory Coast, because he is probably going to be the greatest player we ever play with. Emmanuel Latelath. Let me know if I'm pronouncing that wrong. If I am pronouncing it wrong, let me know in the comment section below. Just want to say thank you very much for tuning in. It's been Frank on the Pitch with Jesus Fabianski. Peace out, everybody, and stay safe, y'all.